In this video, we'll look at how you can transform an object's position or size, and how you can stretch or skew the object, how you can rotate it, and generally just make edits to the objects. And so, to get started, let's go to the browser and quickly create some embroidery from some of the artwork. So here we have an embroidery design, and to get started, we could use our selection tool to click and select a piece of that design. And of course, if I click and drag, I can select multiple pieces of the design. And remember, when I click and drag, only the objects that are fully surrounded by the selection box become part of that selection. Once you've made your selection, then you will see the transform box that surrounds all of the objects that you have selected. The transform box can be changed by clicking again over top of the shapes. So the first, I clicked off of the shapes and therefore let go. So select them again. Click again on the, over top of one of the embroidery elements. And notice that my transform box is changing. I'll get extra close to this. Okay. So when I first click on it, I have the sizing handles. And the sizing handles, you know, perhaps this would be a little bit more easy to see if I turned off of the grid. So let's go to our view menu and tell it to not show a grid. And let's go into our fabric menu and just give it a no texture, so that we can really see the handles of our transform box. So this is what I'm talking about. Right now, these are the sizing handles. And if I click again, now we have the rotate handles. And so it's simply a matter of clicking to go back and forth between the two different methods or modes of transforming. Now, I'll zoom out just slightly to show you. If I grab on a corner handle and drag, I will resize all of the parts of my selection, and I can make it larger or I can make it smaller. I can also click and drag. Now notice, when I mouse outside of the shape and I have my normal pointer, and as I get closer to the shape, when I see this multi-directional arrow, which is generally anytime you're over top of the edge of the outline of your selection, or if you're over top of the actual stitching of your selection, you can click and drag to move the location of these particular objects. So that's how you can size it and reposition it. Now to stretch it, you can go on one of the center handles on either the left or right side or top or bottom, and this will change the shape or the proportion of your objects, and so you can stretch them or elongate them. So the corner handles generally will keep that in proportion, whereas the center handles will stretch your shapes. Now click a second time for the rotate handles, and now the corner handles allow us to rotate all of the objects in our selection to be at any rotation angle. And this point in the center is where they rotate around. And so if I move that center point to, let's say, right there, now watch, if I rotate, it'll rotate around the point where I have selected. When you're during the rotation mode, the center handles can be used to skew or add slant to your selection. And so in these ways, we can easily change the location, the size, the rotation, and the shape of our selected objects. I'll click back to select normal sizing mode. And if I use the Alt key on my keyboard, it allows me to grab on a corner handle and not only change the size, but the width at the same time. In other words, now I have the ability to change the shape of my objects kind of more freely. So that's by, again, holding the Alt key down while performing a resize using the corner handle. If I don't hold the Alt key down and I resize using the corner handle, then it simply keeps those proportions intact. Another way that you can transform your objects is using the Tool Options toolbar, which is found here. And here you'll notice the first two numbers are actually the position of this object or this group of objects. So I can see that they are based on the center of the design being kind of 0 and 0. They are, you know, moved. Watch what happens if I relocate these objects. These numbers change. And so you could use these numbers and change them to be mathematically change the location of your selection. So by me typing in 0, it returned it to the center line of the design. If I made this one 0, it would probably return it right to the center of the design. And so in this way, you can also transform the position, but the size. So you can change the size mathematically, and it's checked right now to be proportional. So if I change the size of this from 21 millimeters to be, let's say, 30, it will keep it in proportion. However, if I uncheck proportional and I turn this back to, let's say, 20, it will not shrink the height, therefore squishing it. And so in this way, you can tell any selection to be a very specific size. So I could make this 20 by 40 and stretch it even more. Also on the object toolbar, the ability to duplicate or scale. I guess I should talk about scale. So this is to type in a specific size, but if you just want to make this all 120% wider but not taller, hit enter. Or if I keep it proportional and I say to make this selection, you know, 150%, it will make both the height and the width the new 150% size. Another thing that we can do from the tool options is duplicate. And when I click on duplicate, it will actually create a duplicate of the shapes that I have selected. And so now we have a new group of shapes that were duplicated from the first set of shapes. And they're currently what is selected. Now, from here, I can also rotate by any specific degree. So if you wanted to go, you know, specifically 10 degrees, you could rotate by that amount. And finally, on this window, we have the ability to mirror by X or by Y the selection. And so in that way, you could easily mirror image, you know, an entire embroidery design. You would simply go Control A and mirror image, or mirror image on Y. And so these are the ways that we can transform the objects of our embroidery designs.